Hey everybody, this is Rishi Agarwal. This is a quick summary of a recent paper that was published in The Lancet comparing lobectomy versus segmentectomy in small, early-stage lung cancers. First, some quick definitions. A lobectomy is when an entire lobe is removed. In this case, the entire right upper lobe is being removed. A segmentectomy is when a segment of a lobe is removed, in this case, the apical segment. A segmentectomy and a lobectomy are similar in that both are considered anatomic resections, which means that the surgeon dissects back to the hilum to clip the origin of the lobar bronchus or the origin of the segmental bronchus. For the purposes of this paper, a segment was defined as the removal of one segment and its additional adjacent segment. In practice, for example, you won't often see a pure apical segmentectomy. More often, you'll see an apical and posterior segmentectomy. A wedge resection is when the surgeon removes a section of lung without regard to segmental anatomy. It's not often used for the treatment of primary lung cancer. Because a wedge is done without respect for the segmental anatomy, this is considered a non-anatomic resection. Now, some background. Prior to this study, the only randomly controlled trial comparing lobectomy versus segmentectomy was published in 1995. In that study, there were higher rates of death and local relapse in patients who had segmentectomy compared with lobectomy. However, that study was done at a time when the use of PET, CT, and advanced lymph node sampling techniques were not as widespread as they are today. This study is a fresh look at that question using modern imaging and techniques. 1,106 patients were included in this study. Half were assigned to segmentectomy and half were assigned to lobectomy. Patients had to have very specific tumors based on imaging. First, they could only have single tumors, so patients with multicentric disease were not allowed in the study. Second, the tumors had to be 2 centimeters or less, which corresponds to T1B in the 8th edition of TNM staging, or T1A in the old 7th edition. Third is that the tumor had to be in the outer third of the lung. In other words, it couldn't be too close to the hilum. And then the patient couldn't have any evident lymph nodes. They had to be clinical stage 1A. One of the secondary endpoints was local relapse, and patients who had segmentectomy were twice as likely to have a local relapse compared to lobectomy, about 10% compared to 5%. However, that did not translate to worse overall survival. In fact, overall survival, which was the primary endpoint, was better in the segmentectomy group compared to the lobectomy group. The authors believe that the preservation of more lung may have contributed to the more extensive treatment for patients who relapsed from their primary tumor, or in cases where other tumors or diseases cropped up, which resulted in overall survival benefit. The implications for radiologists are: 1, segmentectomy is considered the standard of care for small, peripheral, early-stage lung cancers, and 2, radiologists should know how to localize tumors based on the segmental anatomy. If you don't know how to figure out the segmental anatomy on CT, check out my previous video on the subject. All right, that's it for this video. If you have any questions about this topic, let me know in the comments below. Thanks.